Caffeine is great, and coffee beans contain lots of it. 100 milligrams of caffeine in one drink might seem not too much, but it adds up. This tiny innocent molecule is a natural stimulant, a potent psychoactive drug. I'm one of the people who are conscious of my caffeine intake because I love coffee so much. So more and more people like me would choose a decaf coffee, which it has its caffeine stripped out. But have you ever wondered how caffeine is removed from the coffee beans? And what is the price of it? Reduced flavor, maybe? Have you noticed it? Will technologies ever catch up so that decaf coffee fully recovers its original flavor, as if it was never processed? Keep on watching to find out the most important methods used to decaffeinate coffee in today's industry, and towards the end, I will be revealing which one is the best, the greenest. So, let's go! There are three methods for removing caffeine from coffee beans. The solvent method, the supercritical carbon dioxide method, and the newest addition, the Swiss water process. But one thing to get out of the way first is that the decaf coffee needs to be whole, raw, and unroasted, so green coffee beans. It is technically possible to remove caffeine from roasted coffee or ground coffee, but you will lose lots of its flavor and aroma in the process, so it is never really done. Fun fact, your coffee drink today is made up of 55 hand-picked coffee beans, which is about 18 grams. Now, method one, using organic solvents. In the indirect method of organic solvents, boiling water is used to soak the beans to make them softer and to extract out all the water-soluble components. These are the caffeine, and it is important, but also other flavoring ingredients, aldehyde, esters. That caffeine-rich and flavor-rich water extract is drained away from the beans and is mixed with the organic solvent. Now, this is the key. The organic solvent attracts only the caffeine out and leaves everything else behind. With the organic solvent caffeine layer removed now, the water mixture is then reintroduced into the coffee beans to, let's say, recover the flavor chemicals that were lost during the original exposure. And there are tricks and there are patents into the whole reinfusion process to end up with a flavorful coffee bean. That's a trick there. I mean, this is the most popular method for decaffeination worldwide. And I do like it, I guess, because the organic solvent is never in contact with the coffee beans. So no contamination as such. But wait for it, because in the direct method, there is contact. So after the beans are either steamed or soaked, remember to soften them, they are repeatedly dipped directly into the organic solvent. So it takes roughly 10 hours to complete the process. The beans are typically steamed after that to remove any residual solvent. It evaporates after, obviously, thoroughly exposed to the solution. Now you will wonder, which are the solvents? Well, the solvents used are either methylene chloride or ethyl acetate. And they both are not exactly natural, but they are good solvents in what they do, which is extracting caffeine out. With any organic solvent use comes, as I said, the issue of contamination, which is the residues of the solvents that are left in the beans. But yes, it can be tackled by using high temperatures to evaporate any residues. But don't forget that the methylene chloride can be used as a paint stripper, is organic solvent, and degreaser. And the ethyl acetate can be used as a nail polisher. At least ethyl acetate can be found in fruits during ripening, so it's slightly more natural than the methylene chloride is, and thus it's preferred for the direct solvent method. I mean, none of the methods are green, if you ask me, and this process costs a lot of money and is not even environmentally friendly currently. Method number two, using supercritical carbon dioxide. Well, in this process, the coffee beans are steeped in water and then put in a pressure cook-like stainless steel container. And they are extreme compressed, supercritical carbon dioxide is pumped in the beans on and on again for 10 or 12 hours. In these pressures, which are thousands of atmospheres pressures, carbon dioxide properties are supercharged, making it thick like liquid, but still has the properties of the gas. In this state, it can selectively extract caffeine out of the beans. Activated charcoal or activated carbon is usually used to filter the carbon dioxide that contains caffeine before it leaves the container. The carbon dioxide is then redirected into the stainless steel vessel to complete the cycle. This is a fancy and highly expensive method. And now it comes the Swiss water process. Since water is used as the only solvent in the Swiss water process, it is arguably the cleanest way to remove caffeine from the coffee beans. The green beans are first steeped in a solution made of water and green coffee essence. This is a mixture of chlorogenic acids, amino acids, carbohydrates, a whole range of other organic compounds, minerals, and actually zero caffeine and zero beans. Just the essence of the beans. Doesn't contain any coffee. Through a phenomenon called diffusion, it's important, the caffeine is moving from the beans to the green essence because of caffeine imbalance in the two solutions. To recycle, specific activated carbon is used as a filter to separate the caffeine then from the green coffee essence which now contains caffeine. This is a specific filter with pores as small as caffeine. Now, once the coffee beans are 99% caffeine free, the solution is redirected back into them. 10 hours and several cycles later, the caffeine free green beans are sent to the dryer to evaporate. Invented in the 30s, but only made commercially available and viable actually in 2007 in Canada, the Swiss water process is the only environmentally friendly, chemical-free method producing 99% caffeine-free beans. It is gaining a lot of attention lately for its high quality and green credentials. It is the way, actually, that many organic coffee businesses prefer to have and serve decaffeinated coffee. Here we go. At least we can have some decent coffee. And now, which method is the best? Yeah, I mean, don't rush to say the Swiss water. Wait for it. When it comes to decaf coffee, it is a given actually that processing will somehow affect the flavor. Coffees made without caffeine just aren't as rich and as flavorful as the normal ones. Although the decaffeination industry makes every effort to add the flavor back to the beans, they will never be able to truly replicate the flavor of the original bean, right? I mean, this was the case until now. As I said, the Swiss water method promises to fix that. Try decaf coffee that has been undergone the Swiss water process if you want, you know, decaf that tastes as nice as a normal coffee. But between you and me, it is still a niche today. Maybe less than 5% of the decaf coffee market is processed like that. Some people actually adore the flavor of coffee that has been processed by a, you know, typical indirect solvent procedure. Probably it is a habit. Probably it's also the type of beans that are selected to go into this process, the ones that appeal to most people anyway, the standard medium dark roast with chocolate notes. Hardly ever any specialty coffee is going near the decaf factories, right? So anything above 70 tasting score, or even less. Remember, however, that the type of beans, as well as the roasting and the brewing, will have a tremendous, significant effect on the taste. So don't be the first at hooting decaf coffee. There are many, many things at play here. Coffee decaf lovers, your luck is turning, for the better. If you want to hear more about fixing decaf, I have made a YouTube video here above that you could be watching after this one. Links down in the description, just below the like button. Thanks a lot for your attention and see you in the next video. Bye!